Good day, everyone. I'm Teacher Jelly from TLA Volk Department of Jose Abad Santos High School. Welcome, parents, students, and teachers, for our webinar 101. Learning is fun with Teacher Jelly because learning never stops. Nowadays, even though we have a hard time because of pandemic, we are still blessed because we are healthy. Okay, let's start. Are you ready? Effective communication is the key to success in our new normal in education, especially this time of pandemic. So, we are now in different learning modalities of education, like number one, modular pace or the self-learning module. We have the self-learning module. Second, online learning or the synchronous, like the live session or live streaming via Google Meet or Zoom meeting. The third one is the offline learning or the recorded videos. Number four, blended learning. And last, TV and radio broadcasting. So, in online learning, we have a social code or rules online. It is what you call the netiquette. Our topic for this day is all about netiquette for online learning. Okay, what is netiquette? As we define, netiquette came from the root word net, which means internet and etiquette. Internet, meaning, is a global wide area network that connects computer systems across the world. Etiquette is a code of polite behavior in society. Netiquette is an internet etiquette. So in short, it represents the importance of proper manners and behavior online. So, know your manners when using technology. It is a social code that defines good online behavior is something to keep in mind during your online classes interaction. Of course, as a student, use the proper words and always remember to say please and thank you. Be kind and courteous. We have a rule of thumb. If you would not do or say something in real life, don't do it online either. We have rules in netiquette for online learning. First, be respectful. Remember, you are communicating with your classmates, teachers, and parents. So in online learning, be respectful. If you have your synchronous class or live sessions, please make sure to turn off the microphone while the teacher is speaking. Do not disturb the class. If you have some questions, you can ask the teacher after the discussion. Wait for your turn to talk. Next netiquette, be considerate. Your teachers might have their respective consultation schedule. Kindly message them during the scheduled time so that they can accommodate everyone's concern. Next, be on time. As always, they say the time is precious. Don't waste it. Don't be late. If you encountered technical problems or internet connectivity during your synchronous class or live session, like using the platform of Google Meet, kindly tell to your teacher. This is common in online classes. Be ready at least 5 minutes before the class begins and check if your gadgets and connections work well. Next, be ready. Have your learning materials like self-learning module, old notebook, pen and pencil with you. Also, your learning space. It should be comfortable for your online classes. Next, listen carefully and be attentive. Pay attention to your teacher while she or he is explaining and to your classmate while she or he is performing. Next, data privacy. Be careful with what you post online, especially your personal information, to prevent harm. Data privacy has always been important. Your personal information should be kept in private so that your identity stay as safe and protected as possible. We have already a law, her Public Act No. 10173, Data Privacy Act from privacy.com, seeks to protect all forms of information, be it private, personal, or sensitive. Next, be kind and responsible. Check our behavior online. If it is good and appropriate, be a responsible student to do the given task by the teacher. Next, use emoji or emoticons, created as symbols of emotions to express emotions. We cannot always see the facial expressions of people in an online platform. Thus, it is best to be sensitive to what others will feel when we post or share something online. If you wouldn't say it to someone's face, don't say it online either. Next, know to plagiarism. What is plagiarism? Plagiarism, if you're copying the work of other person. The web is full of resources that can help us with our school works. Let us help the owners of these resources by naming them or giving them proper credits. Don't be a credit grabber. Seek first to understand, then be understood. Meaning, understand the power of listening. Highly effective students recognize the difference between actually listening and just waiting to be heard. In order to get your point across, you must be willing to listen and understand others' points first. This takes patience. Spread love, not hate. Kindness can still be felt even in online messages. Avoid using foul words, typing in all caps, or flooding a person with messages. If you need to talk about serious matters, it's better to call or talk to the person. Wear appropriate clothes. If you're dressed nicely, you will feel energized and confident. Be comfortable for your online classes. Reminder, think first before you play. Remember, what you post online speaks volume about who you really are. Post with good intention, repost with caution. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned a lot. Simple reminder to all, stay safe, stay home, stay healthy, and please pray for our world. Once again, this is Teacher Jelly from TL Evoque Department of Jose Abad Santos High School. Have a nice day. Goodbye.